Welcome to Seven Pot Club. I'm Rob.
I grow hot peppers.
I just picked this ripe Rocoto pepper. We're in the final days of November, and although we've already had a fair amount of snow here in Minnesota, today we're enjoying a single day of unseasonably warm weather. 50 degrees Fahrenheit may not seem like a heat wave where you live, but here in Minneapolis, our postal carrier is wearing shorts today. Still over 2 months to go before I start planting seeds for the 2021 growing season. I didn't overwinter any plants this year, but we're still enjoying homegrown hot peppers courtesy of our hydroponic AeroGarden. If you enjoy our content, please like this video, subscribe to our channel, and tap the bell to be notified when we post new episodes. The last AeroGarden episode was back in June, so it's past time for an update. Let's get started.
My roots are in the water, but I'm reaching for the sky.
Here's how the AeroGarden looked when I last featured it back in June. The plants were already producing pods back then, and they've continuously done so ever since. It was 256 days ago, or about 8.5 months, when I planted these two Rocoto plants, both my favorite Ecuadorian red pepper for hell. Since then, I've exerted the bare minimum of effort, adding water every day or two, bi-weekly feedings with AeroGarden liquid plant food, harvesting ripe peppers as they appear. Very infrequently, I'll sweep up or vacuum away the dead leaves that have fallen off. That's it. No pruning, no draining or cleaning of the tank. Have the plants suffered as a result of this benign neglect? Not as far as I can tell. The plants are covered with flowers and peppers, and they're growing in every direction. Much of the foliage is not even under the light array. I'm going to have to do some pruning today, as the plants are threatening to take over the office. Sometimes working at my desk, I sense this branch is trying to reach out and touch me. Kind of creepy. Its intent may be benevolent, but it's got to go. Another shoot has extended itself several feet around the back of my TV, curling around the front as though it's trying to watch. I wonder what channel it prefers. Just look at all the peppers. I don't check often enough for ripe pods, and sometimes they're a little past their prime by the time I discover them. This one, however, is just perfect. I find it interesting how the flowers change color over time. Outdoors, they're usually always a pretty deep violet. Indoors, they seem to vary. At one point over the summer, they were coming in almost white. Now they're kind of an in-between state. The outside of the leaves are pale, while the insides are pretty vivid. The lid needs a good cleaning with vinegar to remove the encrusted lime buildup. I hate doing that during a grow, because I could accidentally mess with the pH of the tank. Inside, the roots look healthy, and the water is nice and clear, so I'm going to leave well enough alone. Okay, time for that trim. My goal is to not cut off any branches bearing green pods. I'd rather let all fruit ripen on the vine. Of course, all the branches are entwined, so unwinding the cut branches is like a puzzle. Some of the branches are really thick, so I had to go out to the garage and get some snips. I'm being so careful while making this cut and removing the branch, I don't notice I'm blocking the camera. First with just my arm, then, as you'll see here in a minute, with my whole body. But mission accomplished, because I didn't disturb any of the peppers. A few more cuts and unravelings, and I'll be done pruning for now. I'm really surprised at how many feet long some of these offshoots are. These plants really were trying to maximize the available space. There, all done for now. I like having plants in my office, but they should definitely stay in their own space and stop invading mine. I do think that two pepper plants are the right amount for this size AeroGarden. Maximizes the use of space, but not so crowded that light can't penetrate through the branches. Here's how much I cut off the plants. This branch has one lone pod that I didn't want to chop off. You know, I'll just tuck it behind the doorknob to keep it out of the way. I somehow missed this ripe pepper hanging down near the floor. A couple of days post-trimming, I pulled the cart away from the window to see if a couple of ripening peppers were fully red. You can see that there are several branches back here I didn't trim because they bear pods. And indeed, these two were ready to harvest. Nice. AeroGarden is definitely the easiest way to get into hydroponics. I'm really happy with how these Rocotos have performed. Last season, I used this unit with the special seed starting tray to germinate some of my seedlings. If I decide to do it again next year, I'll have to remove these plants. If they're still doing this well, it's going to be a tough decision. Maybe I'll need to get a second AeroGarden. My Bounty is a couple of years old, and I'd like to check out the updated model. If you're interested in getting started with AeroGarden, I'll provide affiliate links in the video description if you want to browse and learn about all the latest models and deals.
Our holiday merch sale is on now, with $12 tees and up to 20% off everything in our Threadless store, including our new ugly Christmas sweater designs and neck gaiters. Look, I finally figured out how to create repeating patterns in Photoshop. All our merch is custom printed in the size, color, and style you choose, so it takes a few more days to reach you. Order early to make sure your order arrives in time for holiday giving. And for even more 7-Pot Club, follow our daily exploits on Instagram, Twitter, and Facebook. For 7-Pot Club, I'm Rob.
Perfect.